Hey, it's Blivio here. You are watching Crafting with Blivio, Episode 2, Black Soul Gem Enchanted Necklace. In this episode, I'm going to make one of these here, silver-wrapped black obsidian crystals. I'm going to make one of these necklaces. It's a pretty simple design. It's just some silver wire wrapped around a piece of crystal, and that is hooked onto a necklace, like an amulet. That reminds me, I should have titled the episode Black Soul Gem Enchanted Amulet, but whatever. I've got a few materials out for this project. As far as tools, I've got these round nose pliers. Materials, I've got silver wire and these two different varieties of chains. And of course, the black obsidian wand is what they call this kind of a crystal cut. I'm going to include a link in this video to another arcane crafter that I was inspired by as far as making this design. I knew I wanted a black soul gem necklace, and I wanted a black wand wrapped in silver, but I didn't know how to wrap it. So I watched this guy, I forget his YouTube channel's name, but he was making an actual like oak wood wand, and his technique was pretty interesting. He mentioned he did like positive spirals on all of the wire twists that gave it some kind of... It was a manifestation wand that he was making. So he said that the positive spirals benefited in manifestation. And these are black soul gems. So I'm thinking I'm going to go with negative spirals all the way through. These are actually healing crystals, obsidian. And they say it has some kind of property of, like, you know, absorbing negative energy or protecting you from negative energy. One of those. Either way, that's good. But, you know, I'm more of a Skyrim fan than a crystal power believer. I do place value in all beliefs, and think there's a lot of interesting things that have come up when I've learned about healing crystals. But for me, this is a black soul gem, and it's the only soul gem that can trap a human soul, according to Elder Scrolls lore. But this is going to be a pretty powerful arcane piece of equipment here that I'm making. I'm not really sure how I'm going to start. I've kind of winged it on both crystal designs I made, like the one in the picture to my right, and this one are actually different. This is my original prototype, and I gifted that one in the picture to my right to someone very special to me. But this is going to be number three that we're making here with this crystal. I bought a pack of three crystals, so here's the third necklace. Amulet. I'm going to unbind the silver wire and grab a little bit of it. I just kind of, out of habit, twisted this wire up. I'm going to untwist it now. Okay, so I'm just going to take a little knowledge from sewing that I have. I would usually do like two arm lengths of thread before I thread the needle. I'm going to take two arm lengths of this wire and hope I don't get it all wrinkled to hell in the process. God. Okay, maybe I shouldn't have unbound it all. Oh man, this is bad. Alright, I'm not going to worry about how much length I have right now. I'm just going to try to focus on untangling this. Okay. So there, I've got now one and two arm lengths of this wire here, and I'm just gonna bend it and snap it apart. Maybe not, that's kind of a sloppy way to separate this. Probably not good for my scissors, but I'm just going to cut through this steel wire with my scissors that I use for my hair. Okay. I've got the two arm lengths of wire now, and I'm going to cut it in half again and really have one arm length of wire two times. Okay, we've got this and this to work with now. Before I get started, I'm going to take a look at the chain pieces I have and make sure I've got a good size chain that'll fit me. Now one of these is a finer chain configuration. The other one is thicker, but the chain links are wider also. I'm going to go with the wider chain links just to see what that looks like. So let me open up this package here. Thank you. Looks like this is held together with some fishing line material and a staple. We'll use some cardboard. That's all the packaging there is to this. There's a little baggie at the bottom too. I'm just gonna yank the staple out. And pull off this wire here. Okay, whatever. Now let's get the baggie. It has the clips for the necklace. Sitting here trying to rip it open when I got some scissors right next to me. Oh shit, that went everywhere. Okay. We've got a few of these hoops. And a few of these connectors. I don't know what you'd call them. Clasps. All right. I'll need one of these and one of these deals here. And I'll want to get one of these chains singled out. Let's try to remove this nylon string all the way. And looks like we have one huge length of chain here. I'm just going to kind of do my size and see how that feels. I don't want it to come to about not sure exactly how long that is. I don't really know how to separate this, but I'm going to try to cut it with scissors. Worked. That worked. So I've still got a good bit of chain here. I've got Star Trek playing on the background. It's a pretty good episode. Data makes a child. And he names her Lol. A lot of interesting topics get brought up in that episode. Okay. So now I need to attach one of these little deals here. Okay, and all right, another one goes on this thing. I'll just do that one I just did. All right. That took a while, but I think I got a pretty secure connection going there for the clasp. I'm just going to throw another loop over here, and this will be the part the clasps onto. All right, so I think I made a necklace that fits me. Let's try to put it on. You know what? I like a necklace that can just like be thrown over my head. So I'm gonna make sure I could do that with this. All right, that works just fine. Now we can get on to the more fun part here. Making the wrap around the crystal. All right, so what I'm going to do this is I'm going to find the center of both strands, keeping them together. I will put it slightly above the a lot above the center of the crystal, kind of like a third of the way from the top. I'm just gonna firmly place the wire against the crystal and wrap it a couple times. I want these wraps to go counterclockwise, which I believe is a negative wrapping, because I want to make sure all of the spirals here go in a negative direction. You want to make sure it's pretty firmly wrapped around. It's kind of hard to do with a slippery obsidian surface and a slick silver wire. But I'm trying to get out all the slack that I can. Okay. I'm gonna go one more time around. Right. So now I've got the wire wrapped around the tip of this twice, and I need to go from that to two separate twisted wires. So I'm just going to grab two from each side and twist them in a counterclockwise direction. Right, do this side now. Got three counterclockwise twists on each side. Okay, I'm going to do five now. It's four, five, and four, five. Okay. Now I'm going to come around the top here. No, I'm going to go down, okay. And join these two. And do a counterclockwise turn. Two, three, four, five. One, two, oh shoot, okay, two, three, four, five, right, so if you look at it, you could kind of see it's wrapped around the top and then comes down and as I go down it, it's going to make kind of like a checker pattern in a way. Alright. I'm going to join these here. I brought them down one more time. One. Oh, wrong way. One. Two, three, four, and five. Okay. Bring these around. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, and I'm just going to repeat that until I'm wrapped around. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. All right, so this is where we're at now. I'm gonna wrap these around the bottom here. All right, now I'm going to bring them back up the other way and reconnect them. I accidentally went clockwise on this one. I'm going to try to bring it around and go counterclockwise to fix it. Okay. So, not really sure if you can tell what I've done here, but at the tip, when I've gone back up, they converged into this design here. So I've got these two wrapped points with forks coming off of them, and I'm going to combine opposite sides and twist them. Of course, in a counterclockwise direction. So we've got one, two, and one, two. And four on that side, four on this side, five, six, seven, eight, seven, eight, all right, 10. I'm just going to keep spinning this until my wire lengths can't spin to get together anymore. Okay, so I've got this now, and I've got to figure out how to make this into a attachable thing that can just wrap around this. Maybe we can just do this here. Just killed a mosquito. Okay. So now I'm trying to figure out how to get this into a nice circular thing that can go through my necklace. It's kind of like a spiral right now. This is not coming out as smoothly as I would have hoped. I think I can just leave it like this now. I'd have to hope that it doesn't get too banged up. I don't know. We've got this hoop. Not very clean. But it's definitely sturdy. Not any jagged points coming off of it. But I think I'm going to try to put it on. Alright, there you have it. I made something. Look at that. Black soul gem enchanted necklace. So these are part of the swag I have available as a part of the BlivCorp rewards program. Okay, it's around my microphone here, but you get it. Cool stuff, right? Yeah, there we go. That is made. I don't know. I think I like my original chain a little better. It's a little thicker. So I'm going to take this gem off and put this one on here. All right, that's awesome. So this is it. On my neck. And I just made it. Not the prettiest design, but it's full of very complex magic. So, shout out to that YouTuber who I will drop the name in the comments. And I plan to make a lot more of these on stream, so I will definitely give him some real credit here in future episodes. But for now, I have made jewelry. Enchanted Black Soul Gem jewelry. Very satisfied for today's episode. So, that's it. Thank you for watching. I will see you for the next episode. Be on the lookout for the next bow crafting episode. I'm really excited to make a large quantity of arrows and bows because I've been playing a lot of This Land Is My Land, and I really just want to let them fly, you know. And just to end the episode with a bang here, I'm going to send off my one arrow I made in episode 1. It's got a silver tip with a staple in the very tip of it. So it's a little bit reinforced from the regular bamboo. But I'm going to fire this off before I end the episode here. Now, thank you for watching episode 2, Crafting with Blivio. We're going to do bows pretty soon.